안녕하세요. 반갑습니다. 제니입니다.
Hello everyone. Welcome to Jenny's topic exam. And this time we're going to solve the problems in 27th topic exam. This exam is for the beginners, reading part number 48 to 60.
So, 이번 시간에는 27회 한국어 능력 시험 초급 읽기 영역 48번에서 60번까지의 문제를 풀어보도록 하겠습니다.
Yes.
다음을 읽고 중심 생각을 고르십시오.
Please select the main idea.
중심 생각. 중심 생각 is main idea.
Main idea of this paragraph.
48번,
number 48.
시장은 물건이 쌉니다. 그런데 집에서 너무 멀고 교통이 안 좋습니다. 그래서 자주 갈 수 없습니다. 시장.
시장 is in general, that means the traditional market.
시장 is traditional market. In Seoul, there are traditional markets, like 남대문 시장 and 동대문 시장. 시장은 물건이 쌉니다. 쌉니다 is cheap. 싸다 is basic food.
That means cheap, inexpensive. So, in the traditional market, the products, the price of products are cheap.
그런데, however, contrastive conjunction, 집에서 너무 멀고,
yes, 멀고, that is too far from the house, and
교통이 안 좋습니다.
교통 is transportation or traffic. 안 좋습니다 is not good. That means this place, that is a traditional market, is hard of access by the transportation. So you cannot go there easily by taxi or bus, and there is no space to park. In that case, you can say
교통이 안 좋습니다.
So it's not that convenient. It's inconvenient.
Okay. 그래서 so 자주 갈 수 없습니다. 자주 is often or frequently.
So we cannot 수 없습니다. We cannot go there often, frequently.
Again, traditional market. In the traditional market, the price of the products are cheap.
However, it's far from the house, and it's this place is hard of access by transportation. That means it's inconvenient. So we cannot go there a lot. You cannot go there frequently.
1번. 저는 시장을 좋아합니다.
I like traditional market. No, it's not the main idea of this paragraph.
Number 2. 2번. 저는 싼 물건을 좋아합니다.
I like cheap product. 싼 is a pronoun adjective of 싸다. That means cheap.
쌉니다, 싸다.
싼 is pronoun adjective which describes the noun.
Okay. No, it's not the main idea of this paragraph. 3번.
Number 3.
저는 시장에 자주 갈 겁니다.
I will go to traditional market often. I will go to traditional market often. No, I cannot go there frequently often. No, it's not the main idea of this paragraph. And yes.
Number 4. 저는 시장이 멀어서 불편합니다.
Because 시장, traditional market, is far from the house, far is far from here, so it's inconvenient. Yes, it's far from the house and it's inconvenient. This place is hard of access by the transportation, so it's inconvenient. Yes, number 4 is main idea of this paragraph.
49번,
number 49.
저는 야구를 잘 못합니다. 그런데 제 친구는 야구를 정말 잘합니다. 저도 그 친구처럼 되고 싶습니다.
Here, 야구 is baseball, right? Kind of sports,
운동입니다. 야구, baseball, 축구, soccer,
like.
저는 야구를 잘 못합니다. 못
is a component to make a negative sentence. So, what is
야구를 잘합니다?
That is, I am good at baseball. 저는 야구를 잘합니다. 저는 축구를 잘합니다. 저는 야구를 잘 못합니다. I'm not good at baseball. That means I am poor at baseball. 저는 야구를 잘 못합니다. 그런데, however, that is a contrastive conjunction, like however. 그런데 제 친구는, my friend, 야구를 정말 잘합니다. What is 잘합니다? Be good at. My friend is good at, really good at, is really good at the baseball. Yes. I'm not good at the baseball, however. My friend is good at baseball. 잘 못합니다. And 잘합니다. 못 is component to make a negative sentence. Yes. 저도 그 친구처럼 되고 싶습니다. 고 싶습니다 is want to. So, 되고 싶습니다. Be or become. I want to be like. Like that friend. I want to be like my friend. So, I'm not good at baseball, however, my friend is good at the baseball. So, I want to be like him, right? Just find out the main idea of this paragraph. 1번, number 1, 저는 야구 선수가 될 겁니다. 선수 is player, so 야구 선수 is baseball player. So, I will be a baseball player. No, it's not the main idea of this paragraph. Number 2, 2번, 저는 야구를 잘 하고 싶습니다. 하고 싶습니다. What is it? 뭐뭐고 싶습니다. Want. So, I want to be good at the baseball. 저는 야구를 잘하고 싶습니다. Yes. This writer say, I want to be like my friend. Yes. And this is possible answer. And number 3, 저는 친구와 야구를 하고 싶습니다. I want to play baseball with my friend. No, it's not the main idea of this paragraph. Number 4, 저는 친구보다 야구를 많이 할 겁니다. I will play baseball more frequently than my friend. No, there's no information about it. So number 2, 2번 is right answer. I want to be good at the baseball. So 2번, number 2 is right answer. 50번, number 50. 이번 주말은 아버지의 생신입니다. 우리 가족은 매년 아버지 생신에 여행을 갑니다. 올해는 동해바다로 가려고 합니다. 생신. What is 생신? 생신 is honorific form of 생일. What is 생일? 생일 is birthday. The 생신 is honorific form of 생일. So 아버지의 생신 is my father's birthday. So this weekend, is my father's birthday. This weekend, 주말 is weekend, is my father's birthday. 우리 가족은 매년, so our family, every year, 아버지 생신에, on my father's birthday, 여행을 갑니다. Take a trip. So, our family take a trip to somewhere on my father's birthday, every year. 올해는, 올해 is this year. 올해는 동해바다로 가려고 합니다. 블라블라려고 합니다. That means plan to go to somewhere. Plan to go to somewhere. So, this year we plan to go, 바다 is sea. 동해 is east sea. So, this year we plan to go to east sea. Okay. To celebrate his father's birthday. 1번, 저는 동해바다에 가고 싶습니다. I want to go east sea. No, it's not the main idea of this paragraph. Just, this is my father's birthday. To celebrate my father's birthday, we plan to go to east sea. So number 2, 저는 아버지의 생신을 기다립니다. I
am looking forward to my father's birthday. You know. Number 3, 3번. 저는 매년 동해 바다에 가는 것이 좋습니다.
I like to go East Sea everywhere.
No, this year we plan to go to East Sea to celebrate my father's birthday. Number 4. So it's not a main idea. Number 4. 저는 아버지 생신에 가족과 여행을 할 겁니다.
I will take a trip to somewhere with my family on my father's birthday.
Yes, that is main idea of this paragraph. It's number 4 is right answer. Again, 저는 아버지 생신에 가족과 여행을 할 겁니다.
Then, 다음을 읽고 물음에 답하십시오.
Just read the followings and answer the question. Yes, let's read together.
우리 누나는 과일을 이용해서 비누를 잘 만듭니다.
우리 누나는 누나 is the male word, which means elder sister. So only men can use 누나. Women have to say 언니 for elder sister. But the men have to say 누나 to their elder sister. So
우리 누나, mere meaning of 우리 is our, but most of time in Korean, that means my. So 우리 누나 is my elder sister.
우리 누나는 과일을 이용해서, 과일 is fruit, 이용해서 is use.
우리 누나는 my elder sister, using fruits,
비누를 잘 만듭니다. 비누를 잘 만듭니다.
Make 비누 well. What is 비누?
If you wash your hands, you have to use the 비누. Yes, that is soap. Sorry.
비누 is soap.
So my elder sister make soap well using the fruits. 과일 is fruits. Like 사과 or 딸기. 사과 is apple, 딸기 is strawberry. That kind of things are fruits. Okay.
그 비누는 과일 모양이고 that soap is 과일 모양 is fruit shape. 이고 is an 냄새, smell, is like a fruit.
The shape of the 비누, shape of the soap is like a 과일 fruit. And the smell of the soap is like a fruit. Cause my older sister made soap just using the fruit. Okay.
Then, 누나는 사과를 좋아하는 사람에게는 사과 비누를, 딸기를 좋아하는 사람에게는 딸기 비누를 만들어서 선물합니다.
So my elder sister and 사과를 좋아하는 사람, the person who like apple,
에게는 사과 비누를 apple soap.
So, my elder sister gives elder soap to the person who like apple.
And then, 딸기를 좋아하는 사람에게는
a person who like strawberry soap. So, my elder sister gives a strawberry soap to the person who like strawberry를
만들어서 make 선물합니다.
Give as a present.
선물하다 is present.
The verb present. 선물 is just gift or present, that is noun. But 선물하다 is give a present or just verb present.
So, my elder sister gives apple soap or strawberry soap to the people who like apple.
apple or strawberry. That is, 누나는 사과를 좋아하는 사람에게는 사과 비누를, 딸기를 좋아하는 사람에게는 딸기 비누를 만들어서 선물합니다. 그리고 and 비누에 이름도 써줍니다. 써주다. To do something for the other person. So, my elder sister write a name on 비누. Write a name on 비누. So, whose name? 사람들은 자기 이름을 보고 무척 좋아합니다. The people really like it. Feel happy or feel good. People really like it or feel very happy. Just sing their own name. 자기 이름, their own name. So people feel very excited or people feel very happy. Just sing their name on it. Their own name on it. 자기 이름을 보고. Yes, okay. So, 기억에 들어갈 알맞은 말을 고르십시오. Please find out the appropriate words for 기억 brackets. Here. 사람들은, here. 그리고 비누에 blank 이름도 써줍니다. And then my elder sister write a name on it. And then people feel very happy seeing their own name. So, whose name? Yes, the person who received this present, right? A person who received this soap as a present. So, what is appropriate expression for this bracket? 그리고 비누에 이름도 써줍니다. And my elder sister write a name, whose name? Yes, a person who received the present. And 이름. So, here, number one, 선물을 받는 사람의, a person who receive, 받다 is receive, 선물 is present. So, that is right answer for this bracket. Yes. So, my elder sister write a name of the person who received this gift. Okay. Number two. 누나가 기르는 과일이. Quail is fruits that my elder sister raise. No. My elder sister make a soap. 과일을 선물하는 사람의. A person who present the fruits. No. Number four. 누나가 선물하는 과일을. A fruit the elder sister present. No. So number one is the right answer. So we put this expression and just read it. 그리고 비누에 선물을 받는 사람의 이름도 써줍니다. 52번, number 52. 이 글의 내용과 같은 것을 고르십시오. 같은 것 is correct one. Please find out the correct one according to this paragraph. Number 1, 1번. 누나는 사과와 딸기를 좋아합니다. My elder sister likes apple and strawberry. No, just make a soap which look like a 사과, apple, or 딸기, strawberry. 누나는 같은 모양의 비누를 만듭니다. 같은 모양 is same shape. So my elder sister make a 비누 which have a same shape. No, my elder sister make a various shape of the 비누 like an apple shape or the strawberry shape. No. Number 3. 누나는 과일 냄새가 나는 비누를 만듭니다. My elder sister make 비누 which have the smell of the fruits. 과일 냄새 is the fruit smell. So 과일 냄새가 나는 비누, that means soap which have the smell of the fruits. Yes, number 3 is right answer. And number 4. 누나가 좋아하는 과일과 비누를 선물합니다. 누나가 좋아하는 과일과 비누를 선물합니다. No, my elder sister just present soap for the people. Do not give the present. Do not present just the fruits. Just present, just give the soap, which has the fruit shape or fruit, have a fruit smell. Okay. So 3번, number 3 is right answer.
다음을 읽고 물음에 답하십시오.
Please answer the question. Just read the followings. After read the followings. Okay, let's read together.
저희 안경 가게는 눈이 불편하신 할아버지 할머니께 안경을 만들어 드립니다. 안경을 만들어 plus 드립니다. 한 달에 한 번 사랑의 안경 버스를 타고 혼자 사시는 할아버지와 할머니를 찾아갑니다. 오래된 안경도 고쳐드리고, here again, 고쳐드리고 새 안경도 무료로 만들어 드립니다. 만들어 드립니다. 사랑의 안경 버스를 기다려 주십시오.
There's expression of verb plus 드립니다. 드리다. And here, verb 고치다 plus 드리다. 고쳐 드립니다. And then here, 만들어 드립니다. 드립니다 is honorific form of 주다. So, 만들어 주다, 만들어 드리다. That means to make something for someone, the other people. To make something for someone. Here, 저희 안경 가게는, 안경 is glasses, glasses, that is 안경. And then 가게 is shop. 저희 is honorific form of 우리. What is 우리? 우리 is our. So our glasses shop. And 눈이 불편하신, 눈이 불편하신. 눈 is part of our body. 눈 is eyes. 불편하신, 불편하다 is inconvenient. It's not that comfortable. So 눈, 눈, my eyes are inconvenient, uncomfortable. That means to have poor eyesight, to have bad eyesight. 할아버지, 할머니, mere meaning of 할아버지 and 할머니 is member of the family, which means grandfather and grandmother. Grandfather and grandmother. But most of cases in Korea, that means old people. The old people. Yes. It's not, there is no biological connection with him or her, but we say 할아버지 and 할머니 for the old people. Yes. 안경을, 안경 is glasses, 만들어 드립니다. That means our glasses shop make glasses for old people who have bad eyesight. Okay. 한 달에 한 번. 한 번 is once in a month. 한 달에 두 번 is a twice in a month. So 한 달에 한 번. 한 달에 한 번. 사랑의 안경 버스를 타고 사랑의 안경 버스. That is, 사랑 is love, glasses, bus. Just ride, just take, just ride a love glasses bus. And 혼자 사시는 할아버지와 할머니를 찾아갑니다. We visit to the old people who live alone. So once in a month, we take a love glasses bus and we visit the old
old people who live alone. 오래된 안경도 고쳐드리고 here. 고쳐드리고 고치다 is fix. We fix the glasses which is old. So we fix old glasses. 오래된 is old. Old glasses. We fix old glasses for the old people. And 새 안경도 무료로 만들어 드립니다. And we make a new glasses for them for free. 무료로 무료로 is for free. For free. So we make a new glasses for free for 할아버지 and 할머니, that is old people. 사랑의 안경 버스를 기다려 주십시오. Please wait for love glasses bus. 기다려 주십시오. 기다리다 is wait for. 주십시오 is polite request. So please wait for love glasses bus. Yes. Can you understand this paragraph? Yes. 53번, 53. 이 글의 제목으로 알맞은 것을 고르십시오. Please select the appropriate things for the title. 제목 is title of this paragraph. Number one. 사랑의 안경 버스가 매일 달립니다. 매일? It's every day. So, 달립니다. 달리다 is run. So, love glasses bus is running every day. No. It's a once in a month. It says 한 달에 한 번. Once in a month. It's not 매일. 매일 is every day. So, no. Number two. 사랑의 안경 버스에서 안경을 팝니다. 팝니다 is sell. So, we sell a glasses at love glasses bus. No. They don't sell the glasses. They just fix the old glasses for the old people or just make up new glasses for them for free. So, it's not 팝니다. 팝니다 is to sell. So, just give the product and just take the money that is 팝니다. Sell. No. 3번, number 3. 사랑의 안경 버스가 여러분에게 갑니다. So, love glasses bus is running to you, is go to your place. Yes, okay, this is possible answer. Number 4, 4번. 사랑의 안경 버스를 타고 여행을 떠나세요. 여행을 떠나세요. 떠나세요 is to leave. 여행을, take a trip. So 여행을 떠나다, 여행을 가다 is to take a trip. Just take a trip, just taking the love glasses bus. No, there's no information about travel or taking a trip. So number 3 is possible answer. Love glasses bus is running to you. Is go to your place. So 여러분 is a plural form of you. That is honorific form of you. 사랑의 안경 버스가 여러분에게 갑니다. 54번, number 54. 이 글의 내용과 같은 것을 고르십시오. Please find out the correct answer according to this paragraph. Number 1. 안경을 새로 만들어줍니다. Yes, we make, 만들어드리다, 만들어주다, 만들어드리다, 만들어주다. That means to make something for the other people. So we make glasses for other people. 새로 is adverb, newly. That means we make a new glasses for the old people. According to this paragraph, yes, that is possible answer. And number 2, 같이 together 새 안경을 new glasses 만듭니다. We make a new glasses together. No, just make a new glasses for them for free. 안경을 싸게 살 수 있습니다. We can buy the glasses in a cheap price. 싸게 is adverb of 싸다. That means cheap. No. Number 4. 한 달 동안 안경을 고쳐줍니다. plus 줍니다. 고쳐줍니다. 고쳐드립니다. To do something for the other people. We fixed
the glasses for the old people during a month. No, there is a no expression of 한 달 동안. It's a too long period. Yes. Number one is the right answer for this question. 네.
다음을 읽고 물음에 답하십시오. Please answer the question just reading the following. 네.
Let's read together.
요즘 나무집이나 흙집에서 살고 싶어 하는 사람들이 많습니다. 많습니다.
There are a lot of people
나무집이나 흙집에서 살고 싶어 하는 사람
who want to live 살고 싶어 하는 who want to live at the mud house or tree house these days. So, these days there are a lot of people who want to live in a mud house or tree house.
나무 is tree, 집 is house. Or 흙집. 흙 is mud or sand.
Mud house. 살고 싶어하는. 살다 is live. So want to live. And there are a lot of people. Okay.
나무집과 흙집은 모두 여름에는 시원하고 겨울에는 따뜻합니다. 나무집과 흙집은 모두 is all. So 나무집 and 흙집.
So both tree house and mud house are cool in a summer and warm in a winter. So 여름 is summer, 겨울 is winter. So what is fall? Yes, fall is 가을. What is spring? Spring is 봄. That is 계절. What is 계절? 계절 is a season.
So 나무집과 흙집은 both treehouse and mud house are 여름에는 시원하고 cool in a summer 겨울에는 따뜻합니다 warm in a winter 나무집은 감기에 자주 걸리는 사람들에게 좋고 흙집은 잠을 잘 못 자는 사람들에게 좋습니다
나무집 treehouse is good for the people who catch a cold often.
So 감기에 자주 걸리다 is catch a cold often. 감기에 걸리다 is catch a cold. 자주 is frequently or often. And 흙집은 잠을 잘 못 자는 사람들에게 좋습니다.
So person who cannot sleep well. So the mud house is good for the people who cannot fall asleep well.
잠을 자다 is fall asleep. But 잠을 잘 못 자다 cannot sleep well.
So, mud house is good for the people who cannot sleep well.
So, blank 이런 집들은 계속 인기가 있을 것 같습니다.
So, those house will be or would be popular continuously.
계속 is continuously.
So, these house, what is these house? Yes, it's tree house or mud house. So, why those houses are good? Yes, these houses are good for the health. So,
나무집, tree house is good for the people who catch a cold frequently, and mud house is good for the people who cannot sleep well.
That means both 나무집 and 흙집 are good for the health.
So those houses are popular
continuously. Yes.
55번, number 55, 기억에 들어갈 알맞은 말을 고르십시오.
Please select the appropriate words in 기억 brackets here.
그래서 blank those houses would be popular continuously.
So what is those house? Yes, the house which is good for the health. So, 1번 요즘 시원한 시원한 These days cool. No. 건강에 좋은 good for the health. So 집 is house. House which is good for the health. Yes, number 2 is possible answer. And 나무가 많은 집. So house which have a lot of trees. No. 사람들이 사는 the house where the people live. No. The house which is good for the health. Number 2 is right answer. 그래서 건강에 좋은 이런 집들은 계속 인기가 있을 것 같습니다. 56번. Number 56. 이 글의 내용과 같은 것을 고르십시오. Please find out correct one according to this paragraph. Number 1. 1번. 나무집은 겨울에 춥습니다. 춥다 is cold. So, treehouse is cold in winter. No. Treehouse is warm in winter and cool in the summer. Right? Can you remember it? Yes. Number 2. 2번. 흙집은 여름에 시원합니다. Yes. 흙집. Both treehouse, both 나무집 and mudhouse, 흙집. Both 나무집 and 흙집 are cool in the summer and warm in the winter. So yes, it's a possible answer. Number 3. 나무집에서는 잠이 잘 옵니다. 나무집에서는 in a treehouse, you can sleep well. No, in a mudhouse, you can sleep well. So 흙집 mudhouse is good for the people who cannot sleep well. So it's not 나무집, it's 흙집. Number 4. 흙집보다 나무집이 더 따뜻합니다. So, 나무집 is treehouse is warmer, 따뜻하다 is warm, 더 is more, so warmer than mud house. No, there is no information about it. So number 2 is right answer. 네, 2번입니다. 다음을 읽고 물음에 답하십시오. Please answer the question. Just reading after reading the followings. Yes, let's read together. 울산에는 한국에서 제일 큰 우체통이 있습니다. So, Ulsan is name of area in Korea. That is the southeast part of Korea. Yes, that is name of the certain area in Korea. In Ulsan, 울산에는 한국에서 in Korea 제일 큰 우체통이 있습니다. There is 우체통. What is 우체통? Yes. 우체통 is mailbox. 제일 큰. 큰 is big. 제일 큰 is biggest. 제일 is most. So, there is biggest mailbox in Ulsan in Korea. In Ulsan, there is biggest mailbox in Korea. 우체통 뒤쪽에 있는 문으로 들어가면 이야기를 쓸 수 있는 종이와 연필이 있습니다. 우체통 is mailbox. 뒤쪽 is backside. And 있는 문으로 들어가면, 들어가다 is enter. So if you enter the door, which he is back part of mailbox, there is paper, 종이, paper, 연필, and pencil that you can write a story. Yes, again. 우체통 뒤쪽에 있는 문으로 들어가면 if you enter the door which is back part of mailbox there is
이야기를 쓸 수 있는 종이와 연필이 있습니다.
There is paper and answer that you can write a story with.
Okay. 이야기 is story. 쓸 수 있다. 쓰다 is write.
So can write. There is paper and pencil that you can write a story with.
거기에서 사람들은 재미있는 이야기를 써서 라디오 프로그램에 보낼 수 있습니다.
There, 사람들은 거기에서 there,
사람들은 재미있는 이야기를 써서
just the people write a interesting story and then they send it,
보내다 is send,
they can send it to radio program.
라디오 프로그램,
that is radio program.
보내다 is send, 보낼 수 있습니다.
Will be able to send.
So again,
at there, at that place, the people can write an interesting story and then they are able to send it to the radio program.
기억 blank. 그 프로그램에서
in that program
특별한 이야기를 골라 소개해 줍니다.
At this program
특별한 이야기를 골라
just select the special stories and then introduce this story to the people.
소개해 줍니다.
Blah blah plus 주다 is to do something for other people. So introduce the story to the people.
And then 특별한 이야기, 특별한 is special, 이야기 is story. 골라,
basic form is 고르다, that means select. Okay, choose or select. So at that program, the people select the special stories and then introduce this story to the people.
Okay. 기억에 들어갈 알맞은 말을 고르십시오.
Please select the appropriate words for this 기억 bracket.
Okay. Blank. 그 프로그램에서 특별한 이야기를 골라 소개해 줍니다.
At that program, just select the special stories and introduce this story to the other people.
So, what is appropriate conjunction for this bracket?
Again,
people, at that place, people write an interesting story and then they are able to send it to the radio program. And at that program,
the people just, the person just select the special story and introduce the people to that story.
So,
그런데 is however, is a contractive conjunction, so no.
그러나 is also a contractive conjunction.
No.
그러면 is
and then.
Okay.
That is the answer, 그러면.
And 그래도.
That's even though.
So it's also contrastive conjunction. So 그러면 and then 그러면 그 프로그램에서
at this program they select the special stories and then introduce to the other people. So number 3, 3번 is the right answer for this bracket.
그러면. So 그러면 그 프로그램에서 특별한 이야기를 골라 소개해 줍니다. 58번. 이 글의 내용과 같은 것을 고르십시오.
Please select the yes, correct one according to this paragraph.
Number 1. 1번. 우체통 앞쪽에는 큰 문이 있습니다.
The in front of, no, front side.
In front of 우체통. 우체통 is mailbox.
There is big door.
No.
Backside of 우체통. Backside of mailbox, there is the door.
No.
Number two, 우체통에서 쓴 편지는 집으로 보냅니다.
The letter we wrote at the mailbox, we send it to our home.
No, to radio program.
Okay, no.
우체통 안에서 라디오를 들을 수 있습니다.
So, in the mailbox, we can listen to the radio.
들을 수 있습니다. 듣다 is basic form that means listen to. And 들을 수 있습니다.
We are able to listen to. So, we are able to listen to the radio in a mailbox.
No, just we can write a letter in the mailbox.
In the backside of mailbox.
Number four, 4번. 한국에서 제일 큰 우체통은 울산에 있습니다.
The mailbox, which is biggest in Korea, is in Ulsan.
Yes, number four is right answer.
In Ulsan, there is biggest mailbox. So number four is correct answer.
So number four, 4번 is right answer for this question. 59번에서 60번. 다음을 읽고 물음에 답하십시오.
Please answer the question just after reading those paragraphs.
Okay. Let's read together. 나비와 장미는 작은 물건이나 귀여운 사람에게 어울리는 이름입니다. 어울리는 이름. 이름. 이름 is name. And 어울리는 이름 is suitable name.
That is appropriate name.
So, 나비, which means butterfly, 장미, which means rose. So, butterfly and rose is appropriate name for small objects or cute person. So, 작은 물건, 물건 is objects, things or objects. So, small things or small objects and 귀여운 사람, 사람 is person, 귀여운 is basic form is 귀엽다. So pronoun adjective of 귀엽다 is 귀여운. So cute person. Butterfly, 나비, rose, 장미 is suitable name for small objects or cute person. And next sentence. 태풍이 오면 아주 강한 바람이 불고 많은 비가 옵니다. 아주 강한 바람이 불고 바람이 불고 바람이 불다 it's windy.
So the mere literal translation is that 바람 is wind.
불고 불다 is blow.
So wind is blowing. That means it's windy.
And 비가 옵니다. B is rain. 옵니다 is come. So rain is coming. That means it's rainy. And 태풍이 오면 태풍 is typhoon.
So if typhoon comes, there is really strong wind and heavy rain. There is strong rain, strong wind and heavy rain.
So, 비가 옵니다.
So, if typhoon comes, there is strong wind, really strong wind, and heavy rain. So, please remember the expression of 바람이 불다 and 비가 오다. That means it's windy and it's rainy.
And then next sentence. 그래서 태풍은 아주 무섭고 위험합니다.
So, the typhoon is really awful and dangerous.
무섭다 is awful,
fearful.
위험합니다, 위험하다, that is dangerous. 무섭다, 위험하다.
Awful and dangerous.
And next sentence. 한국 사람들은 이렇게 무서운 태풍이 조용히 지나가기를 바라는 마음을 가졌습니다.
Here, 무서운 태풍.
무서운 is pronoun adjective of 무섭다. So, 무서운 태풍 is awful typhoon, fearful typhoon. And then, 마음을 가졌습니다. That is, have a mind. That is a literal translation. Okay. So, Korean people have a mind that awful typhoon will pass quietly. That is, most of Korean people hope that the awful typhoon will pass quietly without any trouble, without any accidents. Okay. 그래서 작고 귀여운 이름을 태풍에 붙였습니다. 이름을 붙였습니다. 붙이다 is basic form, which means attach. 이름 is name. Attach the name. That is, give a name to something. Okay? So, we give a name, we give a small and cute name to typhoon. So, that's why we give a cute and small name to typhoon. Because most of Korean people hope that this awful typhoon pass without any trouble. Pass quietly. Okay. Number 59, 59번. 다음 문장이 들어갈 곳을 고르십시오. Please select the appropriate places that where this sentence will be inserted. So please select the places where this sentence is inserted. Okay. Let's read together. 그런데 이 이름들을 태풍의 이름으로 사용할 때도 있습니다. So there are some cases we use these names as typhoon's name of the typhoon. So, first sentence. The butterfly and rose is suitable name for the small objects or cute person. They talk about the name of the nabi and changmi. And the second sentence, 태풍이 오면 there is strong wind and heavy rain. So, in the second sentence, they talk about the typhoon. Okay, typhoon. So, in this place, in Giyok place, there must be the contents about the name and the typhoon. So, there sometimes we use these names as the name of the typhoon. Name of the typhoon. So, what is these names? Yes, these names. It's Nabi and Changmi. Butterfly and rose, which is suitable name for the small objects or a cute person. They talk about name and typhoon. There is connection between typhoon and the name. So, the right place for this sentence is 기억, right? 나비와 장미는 작은 물건이나 귀여운 사람에게 어울리는 이름입니다. 그런데 이 이름들을 태풍의 이름으로 사용할 때도 있습니다. 태풍이 오면 아주 강한 바람이 불고 많은 비가 옵니다. Yes. The right place of this sentence is 기역. So number one, 1번 is right answer. And last, 60번, number 60. 이 글의 내용과 같은 것을 고르십시오. Please select the correct sentence according to this paragraph. Okay. 1번. 한국에 오는 태풍은 강하지 않습니다. It's negative sentence, right? 강하다 is strong, be strong. 강하지 않습니다, not strong. The typhoon which comes to Korea, is not that strong. No, the strong. If typhoon comes to Korea, there's strong wind and heavy rain. So it's not the correct sentence. Okay.
2번. 사람들은 태풍을 무서워하지 않습니다.
The people are not afraid of typhoon. No. Most of people are afraid of typhoon. That's why they named a small and cute name to the typhoon. Because most of Korean people hope that this typhoon pass over quietly without any accidents. Okay, so it's not the correct answer. Number 3, 3번.
태풍의 이름으로 물건 이름을 사용합니다.
We use object's name as the typhoon's name. No. No. We use 나비 and 장미, which is a small and cute name, to the typhoon. There's no information about it. Number 4.
사람들은, 4번, 사람들은 태풍에 귀여운 이름을 붙였습니다.
The people give a name to, people give a cute name to the typhoon. Yes, the people give a cute and small name to typhoon because most of people hope that the typhoon pass over quietly without any accidents. Yes. This is correct sentence. Okay. Yes. So far we did reading second reading part of 27th topic exam. So far, so good. Have a good job. 네, 감사합니다.